Good morning, students. Now, in this video, we are going to learn about the helping verbs or the auxiliary verbs. As you know, all these auxiliary verbs are very useful and very important in every sentence. So, see what are their uses and how they are very important. So, let us see one by one. So, auxiliary verbs, another name is helping verbs. Okay, what do you mean by that? See here, helping verbs. So these helping verbs, they help to the main verb. For what purpose? To give the meaning of that sentence and for the identification of that tense. Okay, I am a teacher. See, I use here I am. See, for example, I am a teacher. Okay, see, this am I use here. So when I use this am here as a verb here, it gives a meaning, it gives the complete meaning to the sentence and also tells the tense. It indicates here it's a present tense. Okay, now let us see which are they. Now we will discuss about one by one. Let us see. So see, students, here first we see that to do form. See this to do form or to do verbs. So see this do, does. Okay, and here did. So this do and does for, it shows present tense. Which tense? Present tense. Fine. Now see, did, past tense. Okay, mostly for what purpose we use this? For construction the question, for making a negative sentence, we use this helping verb, or make any kind of WH question, yes no type question, we use this to do forms. See, with example, see here, what do you like? What do you like? See the question. I use here do to make a WH question. See, what, that helping verb do, it also indicate present tense. Okay, it is in simple present. What do you like? We see, do you like music? Do you like music? See, student, here it's a yes no type question. At the beginning we use do, then a subject. Okay, then we make such a yes no type of question. Okay, see the negative question. I do not like music. See here, I do not like music. Do, we simply add not as a negative sentence, then we construct a negative sentence. So in this way we use this do, does in a present tense for making negative sentence, for making yes no type question, and also to making the WH question. The simple, that did, past tense. In this way we can use the same sentences. What did you like? A simple, what did you like? See the in past, where did you go? Where did you go? See again WH question. Did, it indicate past tense. Okay, negative sentence. He did not meet me. He did not meet me. See the did. Subject, that helping verb, that negative word not, and that V1, he did not meet me. It's a negative sentence. Okay, in this way we can use this all do, does, did form as a helping verb, as a auxiliary verbs. Their function is they help to the main verb to give the meaning for the identification of a tense. Here simply all these sentences, they indicates all these sentences are in a present tense. Why? This do or does is there, and here did. So keep in mind, did we use in a simple past for making such a kind of question, such a kind of negation. Okay, I hope you have understood it. Now next, helping verbs are to have form. To have form. See. Okay, students. Now next helping verbs are to be forms. After to do forms, we are going to learn about to be forms. See. Am, is, are. They indicate present tense. Okay. Here was, were, was and were. They indicate past tense. Mostly in a continuous tense, they use as a helping verb. But in simple present, in simple past, they also use as a main verb. Okay, though they are playing role as a helping verbs, but in simple present, MAs are, in simple past, they use as a main verb. Now let us see with example. To see, he is reading a story book. See, he, the subject is as a helping verb. He is reading a storybook. When we use that helping verb, we come to know tense, the action. Okay, the see student here, if is not there, how you can recognize the which tense is there? He reading a storybook, no meaning, no meaning is at all. So when we put here is, it indicates it's a continuous present tense, action is going on. When we use was, it shows it's a past continuous tense, means that helping verbs help that main verb to give the meaning of that sentence. Okay, see, he was reading a book. See, this was indicate past. Okay, this is indicate present. Here we come to know about the tense. So that's the function of that helping verb, to recognize the tense. Okay, and to make a question also, negative sentence also, for that purpose we use this to be form. So am, is, are we use in a present tense, was, were we use in a past tense. See, they are good students. Good students. But see here, are we use as a main verb. See, because after that are, there is no any main verb. So this, they are a good students. So here we, that are is used as a main verb. Okay. Now see, he was with me. See, here was as we use main verb, but in otherwise they use as a helping verb, as a auxiliary verbs. Okay. Now next, helping verbs are, after this to be form, there is a to have forms. Okay. Now after all, we use how to use where. So he, am, we use after a singular subject, after a singular noun, he is. Okay. Am, we use after only I, that he, we use only a after singular noun, as we use here, he is. Okay. And that are, we use with the plurals nouns. Okay. So see, they are playing. They are playing. See, plural subject, we use are. Okay. Now like this, were, they were playing. Okay. So for plural subject we use where and are in a present tense, where in a past tense. Okay, now next auxiliary is a shall and will. Shall and will. Now next form, will and shall, which we use in a future tense, which indicate as a future, okay, upcoming action. This shall will be used for the future actions. So see, when we use that will, see, I, we, then we use here shall, okay, shall. After I and we use a shall, and after other subject, other nouns, we use will, whether they are singular or a plural. So that time we use that will. But when we want to keep our promise, we want to show certainty, definitely, that time we use will after I and we also. Are you getting? When you want to show our certainty, yes, I will help you. See, I will help you. Here, I promise, definitely I will help you. That time we use will after I subject. And when there's a comma statement, we use shall. We shall meet. We shall meet there. Okay. We shall meet there. So that is the difference. See, I will, we shall. I will, it shows our confirmation, our promise, our certainty. And here as a common statement, yes, I shall meet, we shall meet there. But as a grammatical, I and we follow the shall. And when we want to say with confirmation, with promise, we use will after I and we also. Okay, see, Kunal will help you. Kunal will help you. So the future action. So Kunal will help you. We use will here. Okay. My friends will guide them. See, my friends is a plurals. So we use will because, okay, so no choice, we have only will. So, but only I and we follow shall, okay? So in this way, we use this will and shall to show in the future tense, okay? I, we follow the shall, and rest of the nouns, other subjects follows the will. Only if confirmation, certainty, or our promise, definite, that time we use will after I and we. Okay, I hope you have understood it. Now next, to have form. To have forms. Okay, so first we discuss about todo form, to be forms. Now to have forms. So see here. This have and has, okay, they indicate present tense. For what? Have and has, they indicate present tense. And had, it shows past tense. So these are the have and has and had, these are the to have form. Okay, so let us see with examples. See, when we use this have and has, so see, have we use for the which subjects? See, plurals, we have. See, they have an exception, apuvad. Is there only I have? It's a singular noun, but exception is there, and rest of for the plural subject we follow the have. For example, Ram and Kunal have. Okay. Now next, has. When we use has, he has, it has, she has, Kunal has. It means singular noun follows has. Kunal has a good car. Now, and what about had? Had we use in a past tense. Now here we don't have choice. So after had we use singular and plural nouns. Means for any subject, any nouns, we follow only had in past tense. But here only have and has, we have the choice as per the subject. Okay, singular and plurals. Okay, so now I hope you have understood it. There is a difference among this have, has and had. All these they can also use as a main verb, also as a helper verb and as well as the main verb. Let us see. See, he has written a book. He has written a book. See, singular subject. Okay, helping verb has, VPP, then object. Okay, so has as a helping verb, but and then see, we have completed our work. We have completed our work. See here, plural, now we use the have, means singular noun has, plural noun have. Okay, so as a helping verb. Now here, I have a car. So here, that have we use as a main verb. Have, belonging to, belonging to. So I have a car, here we use as a main verb, and here we use as a helping verb, which help to the main verb completed. Okay, like this. Had also, but like have and has, we don't have choice while using the had. So see, he had written a book. It indicates a past tense. Subject singular, we use had. Though they had visited the Taj Mahal. They had visited the Taj Mahal. See, plural had, no choice. So only one had. It shows in a past tense. That have as we use in a present tense. So students, all these are the helping verbs or the auxiliary verbs. I hope you all have understood it. Okay.